All right, we're going to talk about leading lines. So again, when we see a set of plans, we have the big picture. If you go right over here, I don't know if you can, but let's try. This is the house that we're building. So before we ever started, we had an image of this house, and we also have a set of plans. And when we start building the house, there are things called leading lines, and I'll talk to you about what that means. This waterline table here is a leading line for what happens above this line in the brick and below this line in the brick. So if this is 0, this is -1, -2, -3. If this is 0, this is 1 course, 2 course, 3 course, 4 course. So what we wanted to make sure of below the 0 lead line is that we have a full brick. So you can see we landed with a full brick at the slab, but that doesn't always happen. But remember, this is the picture we want. We want a full brick below the water line. The slab actually changes. And if you look right here, you can see the slab jumps up. Well, we don't really care if this brick is cut because there's landscaping here. And so that has zero relevance in terms of how we want this full brick to land under the windowsill. So again, this is the most important thing going on, this full brick below the windowsill. The other thing we had to calculate is how this waterline tile actually hits the windowsill. That's on a totally different day, different video, but it's absolutely intentional and critical on this particular house. So the second thing I want to talk about is what happens above the 0 baseline. And so let's just call this 0 again. We can probably go right here. If you look at this window, you're going to see 2 courses of brick above the window. That's very intentional. So we course out our brick, and let's just say we land at brick number, 43. Well, the way we land at 43 is we make micro adjustments in the mortar. So it's, you'll see some places will have, an 1/8 inch more mortar on this line. And so we use our mortar to then course out the most important thing on this elevation, which are the 2 bricks above the window. We also have what's called coins. And the coins that you see here, you have brick that's stepped out, and then 2 courses, and then brick that's stepped out again, and then 2 courses. So we have this push-pull thing going on. So on the plans, it might say, hey, we need 10 rows of brick here. But in reality, we're working the coins out with the window. And so this count changes sometimes. So again, these are conversations we have with the architects and the designers, in this case, Benjamin Johnston Design, and we very intentionally walk through how this brick will be coursed out. And if I go back to the very beginning here, there's a board that we have that runs from slab to the top of our parapet wall, and it marks every single course so that we can calculate and determine ahead of time how we're going to treat the conditions from 0 below and from 0 above. So we talked about the parapet wall just a second ago, and what we can do with the parapet wall is land on a full brick, which may mean that we adjust the framing slightly at the top to achieve that coursing, which is what happened here. So again, you may see a brick wall and it looks really simple, and it looks really simple because it's really well thought out and executed. So it's organized, we communicate about it, and we execute it, and that's why it looks so simple. So there you go.